Hey everyone, welcome back for part 5 of this Flutter meets Supabase tutorial series. Today we're just going to do a quick cleanup with the authentication. I've seen some comments about issues with the login persistency, so we're going to go ahead and address those. I think I've mentioned them before, but we're actually going to go ahead and just pull in the shared preferences package, and then we're going to be pulling or saving the token from our authentication, and then on the splash page that we implemented previously, we're just going to go ahead and try to re-authenticate with that. We want to go ahead and go to our pubspec.yaml and install that new dependency for shared preferences. Okay, then jump into the splash page, and we're going to move that logic that we had before for authentication into a separate function just to clean things up a bit. Okay, so then we're gonna go ahead and create a constant variable up here, and that's just gonna be a string for the key that we're going to use to store and fetch the session from shared preferences itself. And so the value here in the string can be whatever value, as long as it's a unique value for the shared preferences across your application. So don't use this value to save anything else on that shared preferences. So then we just get the string from the shared preferences by passing in that key, which again doesn't exist right now for us because we haven't added in the code anywhere to save that key into the shared preferences. So here in a bit, we're going to save it right after the session is refreshed and also in our login. So now that we have the session here from our shared preferences, we're going to check to make sure it's not null, because if it is null, it means that it doesn't exist there. So this user is definitely not authenticated. And we just want to go ahead and create some functions here so that we can reuse them. So we're going to call this redirect to login. Okay, so if the value is not there, we're just going to go ahead and go to the login. If it is there, then we're just going to make sure that it has no errors. Oh, actually, I forgot to await here. Maybe not. Oh, I'm going after the wrong thing here. We gotta create another one, another variable here. So this is gonna be the response from our Supabase client after trying to recover the session. So here we're gonna pass in that session. And I guess it doesn't explain too well what the response is, but basically, as long as we don't get an error in our response, we should be good. As you guys can see, the function here pretty much returns with an error whenever there's any issues at all, except when it gets all the way down here, when it's basically saying, yes, this session is valid and the user is still authenticated. So then it just returns a response with the data with no error. And it also goes ahead and saves the current session. So what that means is when you do auth.currentSession or auth.currentUser, you'll have it already. It won't be null anymore at that point. So that refresh itself does set the state for the current user as well. So that's pretty nice. So if we have no error in that response, which is where we need to await, Actually, we can just check if it's null, then we can just go ahead and redirect the login again. And if it's not null, then that means we're good, we're authenticated. So the first thing we want to do before redirecting to home, it's going to be that we're going to want to save that session again in our shared preferences. So we can go ahead and do that based on this response that comes back here. And we're going to use that same persistent session key. But now the value is going to come from that go true authentication response. And it's that variable called persistent session string. And it looks like that's a future, so that's going to be something we want to await. And then we can go ahead now actually. Well, at this point, we have two options. We could just let the normal flow navigation go down here, or we can manually redirect to home. We'll just let it flow through here. But basically, because like I said earlier, recover session will actually set the current user if it's valid. So then when it comes down here, user will actually be set and it'll go into redirect home. So we shouldn't have to do anything else here. But now we do want to jump into our login here real quick. And after a user logs in, again, we have this result that comes in from GoTrue. And right before we navigate to the home page, we also want to do the same logic that we did over here. So we can just go ahead and copy that, but make sure we copy the variable as well. Okay. And we'll need to get this key from the splash page area over here as well. So that means we need an import from this page or this file. But here, instead of using response, it's actually assigned a result. But the variable path is the same. It'll be .data.persistentSessionString. So let's go ahead and import that splash page. You'll probably want to create like a constants class somewhere and then have all your constants be there, like with all your other keys. But for now, we'll just leave it in the splash page and we'll import that in so we have the access to that persistent session key value. And so I think we should be all set. So when a user initially first logs in, we're going to go ahead and get that persistent session string and save it in our shared preferences and then just navigate to the home page like before. But now the next time when you restart the application or when the user comes back with the application, we're going to fetch that value from a shared preferences before we actually check our authentication logic. And then from that, we're going to recover the session if there is one. Otherwise, we just go back to the login. So we can go ahead and give that a try now. Okay, so because we haven't saved that key before, it still prompts us to log in just like it used to do it before. But hopefully this is the last time we have to do that. And we log in successfully, but now when we restart the application, there you go, we're still logged in, we're authenticated. I'll go ahead and throw a debugger here just to show you guys. And there you guys go. We've got the user, we're authenticated. And every time we do that, we save the new persistent session string because again, when you essentially log in, even though you're not manually doing it, but the recover session does that logic, you'll get a new, I believe you'll get a new persistent session string. I could be wrong there, but I'm pretty sure that's what's going on. So that's why you want to save it again, because it'll be a different token values in there. So that's pretty much it. That's a short one, and I think it's pretty easy and straightforward to do. Hopefully we can get this natively out of the Subapase client authentication library and have it do this logic, or at least an option to configure it to do this automatically, so that way we don't have to implement this on our applications every time we do authentication with Subapase. So if you guys think that was pretty helpful, please let me know down below. I think either on the next one, I've seen some comments asking about storage. So we may do something with saving some images or something like that using the storage, but I have not fully checked if the Dart packages are up to date as for Subapase, and I don't know how well storage is supported in Dart, I guess is what I'm trying to say. So if it's not currently supported well yet, then I may go ahead and create those authentication components that we talked about previously. So they'll probably just be these UI components that we've made for this application here. We may possibly clean them up a little bit on that video and maybe add some configuration and settings to make it a little nicer. But we may throw that logic there for having that persistent authentication in those components. So that way, if you guys pull in that library or package, then you guys don't have to set all this up every time. So please let me know if you guys like this video down below, and comment again as usual what you guys want to see next, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you.